Chasing round one is upon us, and if you are somebody that enjoys the ground fight game, this matchup could be customized.
This fight is made for you, but does the grappling keep this fight standing? Does he just throw the jiu-jitsu fighter down and then back out? Because even though he's a phenomenal grappler, he will be at a disadvantage if this fight takes too much time on the ground in the jiu-jitsu realm.
You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground. Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now. Well, he's more than content to work off of the back. DC, where he has been a magician in his UFC career. Well, the ground and pound is there once again. Strong work here by Curtis Blaydes.
He's putting him in exactly the position he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights,
being applied here as he works out of side control.
Oh man, the ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets. The problem is the opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land his beautiful ground and pound combination.
On 2 minutes in round one. Fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High level grappling can really be entertaining.
Right side control now, DC. You know he's in his element on the ground. A lot of tricks up his sleeve.
A lot of tricks.
Cormier's pass is denied. On the ground.
It was bad, but now it's not so bad. What a fantastic.
Oh, it looked like that left hand found the target.
Found the target as it has on so many occasions.
Oh, nice work, Saban. Tags him with the left. Oh, tags him with the left.
That left hand has been truly effective.
From that previous round, DC punches in. All right, round one is done. Here we go with the start of round two. You look pretty good, DC. And that man, Curtis Razor Blades, stuffs the takedown there. How good is the takedown? From guard and doing a pretty good job, I might add. Sound strike on the ground. So inside the open guard of his opponent, you gotta be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Side control now. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. All right, half guard form here and a lot of offensive options, I would think, at his disposal.
Oh, he's got a ton of options. He has submission options, but I believe the safest option for him here is going to be to use his ground and pound. Build a base, posture up, throw big strikes, get back in position, posture again, throw big strikes, and just really wear him down with a really secure position in half guard.
The top pressure being applied here. Cormier's looking to pass here, denied by the opponent.
Switch the position. Fantastic movement by the bottom fighter.
Is having his way with him here. Working on side control here. His opponent trying to control posture, but you gotta be careful here. All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. Blades is attempting to pass here, but he's denied by the defense. Well, you know, I don't like the knee very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in the gi at some point in life. He's been in the gi so freely.
Let's get to jiu-jitsu next week. So pretty good damage here with the ground and pound. Nothing superficial about these strikes. They are intending to harm.
Oh, yeah, he's landing very accurately, and he's landing to get damage on.
72 total strikes have landed for Curtis Blades. Landing with 80% accuracy against Daniel Cormier. Well, if you like Muay Thai striking, this might be your moment in this fight as he gets.
What a rusher. That's an amazing takedown. Things that you see in every jiu-jitsu gym around the country.
Ready, fight? Ready. Third round underway. Being applied here as he moves out of side control. Man, isn't it fun to watch this dude work on the mat?
He's unbelievable how fluid he is in his motions on the mat.
All right, good move by him here on the ground. He really is a master of these transitions.
He is a master of movement on the ground. You never know where he's going
to
be.
All right, well, he continues to manhandle him here on the ground. Now maybe try to get to a choke position here, DC. All right, side control now. We'll see if he can advance position. Solid strike on the ground. Good movement by him here, transitioning very well on the ground tonight.
Step for step, he's staying with his opponent in every transition.
Lands a strike now from the bottom. Nice work there by Cormier. 3 minutes now to go to decide this one. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up.
Shots from the top.
Working pretty effectively from the top here. Nice grounded down by Blades. Outstanding grounded down here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He is not putting back. He's not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel it. Oh, nice right here.
All right, got to be careful playing around inside his guard.
Absolutely, John. That's why you don't sit in the full guard. When you sit in the full guard, it gives these guys too many opportunities to chase submissions. And now he's jumping on a triangle.
Pretty good work with the ground and pound here by Blades. Both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
That's a good ground and pound by him here. Certainly staying busy, and not just busy, but effective.
You can just throw punches to keep the referee off you. This guy has thrown punches to be effective, to throw damaging strikes. He's doing a fantastic job.
45 seconds remaining in the round. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of his position up the bottom. That usually makes you tap.
right, let's get you some highlights now as this one goes the distance, DC, and a lot to like in terms of his takedown game. Really took it to that requisite next level here tonight.
He took it to the next level. He's a guy that you know what's coming. You know that you have to defend the wrestler. But even if you're trying to prepare for it, you never are in the training room with anyone that is just like him. And when you come into contact with him, you understand the difference in training opposed to being there with him. He put the grind on this guy, and he got a convincing victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All three judges score the contest
30-25.
For the winner by unanimous decision, Curtis Raisler!
All right, congratulations to him. He is your winner by unanimous decision and certainly a dominant performance here tonight.
Yeah, he did a great job of just dictating and controlling all the engagements of this fight. His opponent never really had an opportunity to lead the dance. He did that start to finish, and he wins a unanimous decision.
Back on my bullshit. Back to back on my bullshit. Matter of fact, that was bullshit. I'm going back to back to back on my bullshit. Do it one time, they gon' think it's luck. Gotta hit them with the repeat. Do it two times, they gon' still doubt. Hey, now I got a three-peat. Gotta flood the streets till they knee deep. Gotta stay woke, can't be sleep.